A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 23rd November, on the front page you have Uddhav to be Maharashtra CM. So government formation is being negotiated in Maharashtra. Three political parties, Congress, NCP and Shiv Sena, have come together for government formation. And now the NCP chief Sharad Pawar has announced Shiv Sena chief Uddhav Thackeray to be the nomination, the name for Maharashtra CM's post. And talk on government formation still continues. Then below you have GDP slump will hit $5 trillion target, warns Niti Aayog. So the road to $5 trillion economy by 2025 is beset with many speed breakers, is what Niti Aayog has warned the government. So it has been said to begin with, nominal GDP growth as such, the term also nominal GDP growth is explained, it is measure of growth without accounting for inflation. So nominal GDP growth has to be at least 12.4% on average if the target of $5 trillion economy has to be achieved, which the government has set for itself. So Niti Aayog CEO Amitabh Kant said this, presently the current rate of nominal GDP growth is 8% in the first quarter of current financial year. So the scenario has been put forth. And this is Aadhaar data. Supreme Court seeks government reply to petition. So bench of Chief Justice of India S.A. Bobde and Justice B.R. Gawai of Supreme Court, the two judge bench, has asked Union Government and UIDAI, which is the apex authority for Aadhaar, Unique Identification Authority of India, to respond to a petition alleging that recent amendments to Aadhaar law opened the back door to private players to access citizens' personal data. So this is regarding the recent Aadhaar amendments. Now they have been challenged in the Supreme Court and central government and UIDAI have to reply. And below you have center Punjab at odds over stubble burning. So stubble burning data was put forth in parliament before the Rajya Sabha. Union Agriculture Minister Narendra Singh Tomar said that paddy harvesting as it is at its fag end, so stubble burning is also ending now. So the data which has been collated, the central government says stubble burning has declined 19% in 2019, including 16.8% decline in Punjab. However, Punjab Pollution Control Board data shows an increase of 2.3% in the number of incidents. So this is conflicting data which has come forth. When Punjab Pollution Control Board says the number of incidents have increased and central government says that events have declined. Then on page 8 you have Supreme Court rejects Karnataka plea on lakes in Bengaluru. So Supreme Court has rejected a petition by Karnataka government against National Green Tribunal order to deposit 500 crores in an escrow account for failure to check pollution in three lakes in Bengaluru. So this was NGT order against Kerala government in December 2018. So against Karnataka government. So Karnataka government wanted to have this case before Supreme Court, but Supreme Court has rejected Karnataka government's plea. Means Karnataka will have to follow NGT order. And here you have Amravati finds a place in political map. So Survey of India has released a new political map of India with Amravati as the capital of Andhra Pradesh. So earlier the map which was released showing after 31st October 2019 when two new union territories have been formed replacing the state of Jammu and Kashmir, that is Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh as union territories, that map showed Hyderabad as the common capital of the two states, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, which have been formed in 2014. So Hyderabad is working as the common capital, but Andhra Pradesh has selected for itself Amravati as its capital. So now this new map shows Amravati as the capital of Andhra Pradesh, which has been released by Survey of India now. Then below you have building bridges of friendship across oceans. So naval officers from seven nations are being trained along with their Indian counterparts in Kochi. So these naval officers are from seven nations including Bangladesh, Indonesia, Malaysia, Myanmar, Morocco, Sri Lanka and Tanzania. So they graduated from Indian Navy's Anti-Submarine Warfare School on completion of their course. And it is said it was the first time an officer from Morocco had come down for training at Anti-Submarine Warfare School of India. So this is, you can see how bridges of friendship are being built across nations with these countries. So this also speaks of how with Malaysia we have had exercise Milan in 2014 when here the lieutenant from Royal Malaysian Navy had participated and now he is here, he had an occasion to interact with his counterparts in the Indian Navy. On page 9 you have Navy gives Shivangi wings to follow her dreams. So this is regarding Lieutenant Shivangi. She has completed her courses, as such you can see. And now the last 6 months as such have also been completed with Kochi based Indian Naval Squadron 550, which is known as Flying Fish. So she learned to fly a Dornier maritime reconnaissance aircraft here, and now she'll become the first woman, you know, as such on December 2, sub lieutenant Shivangi. She'll earn her wings and make history as the first ever woman to steer an Indian naval aircraft to the skies. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Poles Apart. So this is talking about Maharashtra government formation in, as such. So we have seen the three political parties which are politically incongruent. Congress, NCP and Shiv Sena are coming together. So the incongruity of the Maharashtra alliance, the editorial says, can't be overcome by a common program. So the instability of this coalition and incongruency of this coalition is being stated here. And the second editorial, occupation rewards. So this is regarding Israeli occupation. So Israeli occupation in West Bank is considered illegal by international law, under international laws by UN and other European countries, Asian allies of USA. But USA recently announced that Israeli settlements on West Bank are not illegal. So this Israel's defiance of international opinion on West Bank settlements is now finding support in USA. The lead article, the opacity around electoral bonds. So this talks about electoral bonds. We have seen they are being criticized that the donor's identity is not known. So this lack of transparency means we don't know who the donor to a particular political party is. Means, is he an Indian or a foreigner can also not be known. Which company, it cannot be known. So if big money entirely funds elections in a secretive way, then democracy as we know it will not exist. So this is a warning being put forth here. And below you have no light at the end of Brexit deadlock. So Brexit is proposed in UK, means Britain exiting from European Union. The Brexit referendum took place 3 years ago, and now second general elections will take place since the referendum has been held. But clashing political parties in UK are poles apart on their positions, like they're further drifting apart from their positions. So some political parties have a stand that Brexit should not take place, there should be a referendum again to find the people's opinion on whether they want a Brexit or not. Some want a soft Brexit, some political parties call for a hard Brexit. Present Prime Minister of UK, Boris Johnson, wanted Brexit on the deadline without any extension. So there are these differing viewpoints. So that is discussed here. Then on Saturdays on the op-ed page, you have Hungry Tides in the Sundarbans. So this is regarding Sundarbans. Here, Ghoramara is the location which is where residents are being forced to migrate to migrate as such, because this small island is slowly being submerged by the sea. Environment experts are now warning that neighboring islands of Ganga Sagar and Mausuni will also face a similar fate. So these are this is a report on life on fragile islands of Sundarbans. Here you can see these are the Sundarban islands. On page 12 you have Centre has no plans to privatize railways, Goyal. So this is the government now announcing. The Railway Minister Piyush Goyal informing the Parliament that government does not plan to privatize the railways but will outsource the commercial and onboard services of a few trains to improve service delivery. So this is what has been stated. Then on page 13 you have 365 terrorist incidents so far in Jammu and Kashmir this year. So 2013 and 2015 recorded the least number of attacks since 1990 is what government data reveals on terrorist incidents in Jammu and Kashmir. And below you have Center defers deportation of 6 Pakistani Hindus. So Union Home Ministry has put on hold a notice served by intelligence wing of Rajasthan Police and Foreigners Registration Office on 6 Pakistani Hindus staying in Nacha village in near Pokhran in Jaisalmer district of Rajasthan. So the Rajasthan state government is asking them to leave the country for violating visa rules, but Home Ministry has put this notice on hold. And this is regarding RCEP. Japan still wants India to join RCEP, which India opted out of. Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. So Indo-Japanese maritime and military initiatives have been undertaken. That is also detailed out. So this is important. On international page, you have political settlement alone won't end violence in Afghanistan. So US says a peace deal will enable Afghans to work together against extremists. So it says political settlement as is being called for by various stakeholders, that you know there needs to be a political settlement as such, but US says peace deal is required, not just political settlement. So it was negotiating peace with the Taliban, but then it called off the talks. We have seen how Trump abruptly called off talks with Taliban. On business page, you have SEBI may permit promoter reclassification. So listed firms may soon get power to reclassify promoters as public shareholders if such entities lose control of the companies due to reasons like sale of pledged shares or corporate actions such as merger and acquisitions and other triggers. So SEBI is looking into the regulatory framework for promoters to lay down parameters based on which control can be assigned, ascertained, and the obligations of shareholders decided. This is going to take place now. So a committee has been formed to look into this matter by SEBI. And final report of the committee will come when decision will take place. So this is an aspect which has been looked into. And this is policy to hasten piped gas infrastructure on the cards. So national policy on city gas distribution is to speed up development of infrastructure for supply of piped natural gas to households as well as CNG for automobiles and industrial units is on the cards. So Petroleum and Natural Gas Regulatory Board has formed a high-level committee comprising of its senior officials and those of city gas distribution entities. So it will undertake a detailed review of all the issues which should expedite the development of piped gas network, and a policy would be put forth. And this is RBI appoints 3-member advisory panel. So DHFL case will continue. We don't need to go through it every day. This is GST Council Finance Panel should work in tandem. So, Chairman of 15th Finance Commission, N.K. Singh, has called for symmetry in the working of GST Council and the Finance Commission. So, the Finance Commission recommend distribution of revenues between union and states and thereafter among the states and further to the third tier, the panchayats also. So, from the states they go to the third tier. So what is asking for is, while Finance Commission looks at projections of expenditure and revenue, the issue of GST rate exemptions, change charges, changes and implementation of the indirect tax are within the domain of GST Council. So both should work in tandem. So that is it. Then the last page has sports related news. So these were the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asha.com. Thank you.